Thank you so much, Sherry, for being here today and giving us this free information so we can adapt to this new world we're in.
Okay, thank you so much, Barb. All right, is that a little bit better, guys? Maybe lift it up a little bit. I actually am wearing heels too, just to make sure that I am wearing what I normally would if I would be teaching a class. So thanks again, everybody, for joining us on here. I'm going to give you just some really good tips on how to do your own virtual open house tours. We know that that's something that has become our new normal, or maybe just our next normal. You know, who knows? Maybe this is the way we're going to be doing it from here on out. But just working with some agents, I found some really good tips, and I'm just going to be able to share them with all of you guys. So basically, there's three parts of doing a virtual open house. And the first one is getting it set up. And that's really where you're going to be spending a lot of your time too, because you want to make sure that it is getting out there to the public and that you have the right equipment. You've got a script, you've done your practicing and everything. So what I recommend is setting it up as a Facebook event. This is just something where so many people are working from home now that most everyone is on Facebook. I'm sure some of you have been on Facebook a lot more than you ever thought you would. And just rest assured that the rest of the world is doing that as well. You want to look at where the house is and maybe look at some of the people that are on your Facebook feed. So some people are doing it at like 9 o'clock in the morning because that's when everybody is jumping on, they're getting ready to do their day. Some people are doing it at noon, like, hey, you know, take a lunch break and check out this house. And then other people are doing it in the evenings. You know, again, it may not have been a good time to do it before, but there are a lot of people in the evenings, and certainly doing it on the weekends is still an option. So that's the first thing that you really want to do, is just talk with the homeowner and look at your sphere and pick a good day and time that's going to be able to broadcast your open house to the most people. Now, when you're setting it up in here, make sure that whatever account that you're using is what you're going to be using in order to do the video. So the first ones that we've done were a live virtual open house tour. I've actually come up with like a couple more ideas that you can tweak on that, because as we found that Facebook Live has been crashing for a lot of people, and you know, they had events scheduled and they weren't able to get on. So got a different, you know, options on that. And like with all of us, I'm sure that what we're finding is we are just evolving and try to figure things out as we go along. So the first way that I recommend setting it up again is to do a live tour. And then people will basically click on your name. And even if you're doing it from your business name, typically when you go on Facebook Live, you are going from your personal account. So just do a little check on that and just make sure that when you are setting it up that people know how to find you. I've always recommended as part of realtor safety that you never want to do an open house by yourself. And so even in the virtual world, that still holds true. And what this means is that getting your partners to come in and to be able to be guests and to help you share and promote your virtual open house. So this is when you're talking about like your favorite lenders, your favorite title people, home warranty, the people that did the video for the house, possibly that took the pictures. So again, some of your partners that you would work with anyways in getting your listing to go live on the MLS, those are the people that you definitely want to make sure that they are participating and helping you share and promote your virtual open house tour. One thing that I did that worked really well is that I told the agent that for everyone that comments, their name would go into a drawing to get a gift card. And this worked out really well because actually the homeowner had told everyone, and this is what the agent shared, is that their house was a 2-minute walk from Miso or a 10-minute walk, maybe a stumble from downtown. And so that way I was able to pick a downtown restaurant. And so again, just continuing to tag and share and like, and whenever you have people commenting on anything, that is what is going to bring your story. It's going to get a lot more shows. It's going to bring it up to the top of the news feed. So that's just some little kind of Facebook tips. So, okay. All right. So let me see what else in here. My recommendation is that you set it up for about 30 minutes. Again, any longer than that, I think you're really going to lose people. And trying to walk around a house and think of things to say for any longer than about 30 minutes is really hard. So again, just like what we did with this call, again, it's we all try to be, you know, on time and everything, but sometimes it's just getting used to the technology. So you just want to kind of give a few minutes before you actually start. Now, a couple other ideas is that another agent actually used the Matterport video. And again, that's something that your photographer would probably be able to help you with. And that's where they have like virtual tours of the house. Like when you can walk through and you can like step on a little circle and then, you know, it kind of takes you around the whole house. So you can show the Matterport video and then be talking at the same time. So you're not actually, may not actually physically be at the house. Something else too is instead of doing live, you could go and take a tour of the house. And again, if you're not really comfortable in front of the camera, like, I mean, I'm super shy, so I have a really hard time getting in front of the camera. Okay, come on, I better see some of my friends laughing on there. So you may just want to do a video and then plug that in into your Facebook event. Okay, hold on. Just looking at my notes here. So again, that's the part of getting it set up. I've also been encouraging everyone too that instead of, we used to do separate open houses and brokers open, like one was open to the public and one was open to the agents, just do it all together now. So you're just basically doing, it's a virtual open house tour and it's open to everyone. This is where you can do a little bit of boosting in Facebook, again, for your target audience. So, you know, if your house is close to like, you know, middle, elementary, high school, you know, you're looking at a certain like age group, target audience, you know, maybe a certain price point and everything. So those are different things that you can use if you decide that you want to boost your event. So just, again, just lots of different options.
Sherry, we can't do age groups anymore. Unless it's you got to include everybody legally, like
right. Yeah.
18 and up. You can't distinguish, even if it's a 55 and older community, you got to. Right.
Yes. You know. So thank you, Linda. Yeah. So I mean, you're definitely going to need to get a little bit creative with that. And of course, I mean, again, this is something else too, where, you know, just because it's something that we're doing today may not be something that we're doing, you know, tomorrow, because everything is just changing and evolving so quickly with all that. Another way that you can do it though is in your description of your event. That's where you can use the hashtags and use buzzwords. So again, if someone is looking for a 55 and up community, that's where you can put that in the description. And then also too, when you're sharing you're gonna share the event, but then like in your comments, that's where you can add, you know, some, like I said, some of the buzzwords, like close to downtown, close to VRE, you know, close to schools or different things like that. So, because when people are searching, that's what they're going to be looking for. You know, does it have a walkability score? Does it qualify for any special financing? You know, again, so those are all some really good buzzwords to use when you're sharing the event and also in your description. Okay. All right. So that's a little bit about kind of getting it set up and who, you know, who you're inviting, you know, make sure, you know, I mean, even if it's the people in your house that are on there, again, if they're viewing it, then people around them are seeing that they're viewing it. And so it just continues to share. Any questions or comments with that first step?
Sherry, I did have a question in reference to one of the first comments that you made to post on, you can post through your personal Facebook account.
Right.
But it is a business video. Facebook's not going to like come down and hammer you for that.
Well, so the way that it works is that everything is set up through you personally, and then you set up the different accounts, but it's all attached to you as one person. So your business accounts are all attached to that, and so as long as you are, you know, clearly stating your name in the video and who you're with and your contact information, that should meet all the requirements that NAR has. But that's a really great question, and I'm going to refer back to our fabulous FAR members if you want to answer that in the chat for us, or we can just circle back around in the end and just make sure that there are not any issues with that. Let me see.
We use our business page on the personal, so it's our personal Facebook, but we're using our business page to post this?
Yes.
I thought you could I did think you could do videos through the business page, obviously.
You have to make sure that you have got your settings in there. So not everyone knows how to go deep into their settings and figure out how to do it.
Okay. Yes. Okay.
I'm just wondering how we keep this from being just so overrun with it that everybody, you know, that buyers become numb to it. I mean, what suggestions do you have there?
Well, so again, this is one thing where I was saying, you know, that you're definitely, you want to keep it to the 30 minutes, and you may even decide to do it just like 15 or 20 and do it like a couple different times. You know, I mean, the average attention span is quite short. And so again, you know, you just want to make sure that you have like a really good catchy title. And that, you know, stay home, stay safe, buy a house, you know, I mean, you could do lots of different things like that. And that would be, you know, something definitely chat with your, you know, and any other agents that have any ideas, talk with marketing people and stuff like that. And again, this is something where, you know, in the state of Virginia, we're all being told that we're going to stay home until June 10th. So hopefully that's going to be not that far away, or if we won't have to do it for quite that long. But I mean, it may be something else too, where like you're getting together with like somebody else in the office, and you're actually going to do a virtual house tour of maybe some of the houses in the same neighborhood. So then you're going to do three houses. And I actually watched another one. Now on their team, they actually had a professional a videographer that was following them from house to house, but that way they were actually showing two of their listings that were in the same neighborhood. But you know, I mean, two agents from two different offices, just like we used to do before, is to do, you know, like a traveling tour, you know, and to be able to look at more than one at a time. Did that answer your question, Teresa? Okay.
It did. Thank you.
Okay.
I was having earlier technical difficulties and had to take a quick phone call, but I did want to say, for something good, I got two ratified contracts this week. So buyers are out there. Thank goodness.
Whoa.
Yes. Awesome.
Wow.
Yeah. Yes. Clappy hands. Yay. So yeah, I mean, and it is something, is that, you know, not everybody, you know, this is not the time to be, you know, to be judging people or whatever. You know, everyone really has to do what you feel like is best for you and your family and your business. And
like
so,
my epic failure of live last Friday. Oh my God.
Yes. Well, so that's why, Teresa, I actually brought up the idea of just doing a video because live is crashing for a lot of people. So, I mean, so there are, you know, a lot of different ways that you can do it. And let me just back up.
It was humiliating, here. Guys. I couldn't get on. It would not load. Everything was there. It was ready. I had huge advertisement for this and then nothing. It would not happen. So I just did a video real quick and loaded it. Was it that, did it turn out that bad, Sherry, you think? Because then the event down. I didn't know what else to do.
Yeah, no. And I mean, again, I think that, you know, this is just something that we are all going to have to really get used to. You know, I mean, internet crashes, Facebook crashes, you know, all different things like that, that are all going to be going on. And we just have to figure out a way to adapt. And again, to come together as a community with all of us at FAR. And that's why, you know, FAR is continuing to send out all the information. So I hope you guys are checking like your emails and stuff. But, you know, all the different ideas and addendums and, you know, how things are changing really on a daily basis. So as long as we're all just, you know, working together, if you see something that you think is an issue, you know, call the agent up instead of just call them up and say, hey, you know, I noticed this. Do you think, you know, ask a question, have a conversation. It's so much better. So so anyways, all right. So when you're doing the tour, and again, this is where we're trying to show, and someone else said this, is that, you know, we're not so much social distancing as we are physical distancing. And when you say that's true, because we are all being a lot more social through text, through email, through social media. I know that I am. I was pretty social before, but definitely still continuing to be social, but it's the physical distance, you know, that we are, okay. it's the physical distance that we are, you know, dealing with right now of not being, you know, that 6-foot rule. So when you're doing a live or either when you're doing a video tour, it is you that is walking around the house and there is no one else there. So again, you know, you need to talk to your clients if there is still someone living there and just make sure that they are, you know, kind of staying out of the way if they go outside, run to the store, you know, whatever. You know, just, but just want to make sure that you pretty much are going to be there by yourself.
My shameless plug, all my houses are new construction and you can give the codes to your buyers. You don't have to go.
Oh, okay. Awesome. Okay, so now we're talking about doing the video. And again, this is something else that that you want to make sure that you have like the right equipment. Most of us are going to be doing it, you know, like on our phones like this. There's my babies. So you're going to be doing it with your phone, and they do make some really cool things. There's like, it's called a gimbal. It's a stabilizer. Because the last thing you want to do is make everyone that's watching it feel like they're getting sick because you're like shaking your phone like this. So that is something that you can do, a stabilizer. Or, you know, again, if you have someone there and you want them to video you, you know, just make sure that you're standing, you know, keeping that distance. And you want to try to start outside. So again, just like if someone was driving up to the house that they wanted to see, they're going to look outside. They're going to want to see the neighborhood, you know, what the yard looks like. That would be a great time to put the phone on the sign in the yard. So again, that everyone has all of your contact information, knows who you work for, knows how to get in touch with you, and if they have any questions. Now, there are some houses, I know someone did one, it was like a week ago, and it's really close to 95. So they purposely stayed inside because they knew if they stood outside, you would hear that a little bit more. But generally, as a rule, you know, you're starting outside, kind of waiting for everyone, you know, waiting for a few people. And guys, here's something too, is that you may do your first one and no one shows up but me. So always invite me, I will show up. But you want to wave and thank everyone for being there, okay? just like if you were doing a regular open house. Sometimes we know that, you know, we've had 15 people come through, we've also had zero. So just want to try to stay upbeat and positive, wave to everybody, thank everyone for being there, and then just go ahead and start the tour. Because even if you're doing it live, the gimbal is actually an attachment. Linda and I will get some more information on that for you. Actually, one of my agents is doing a virtual open house at 12:30 right after we're done. So some of you guys can just kind of hop on there and see the way that he's doing it. He's one of the first ones I started working with this like several weeks ago. Okay. Okay, all right, so Barb has just said best practices is to do a live event from your business page or to create an event and do the live feed from the event page. So again, you may be going live, but it's coming through the event page. So everyone can see that it is a business event. Does that make sense, guys? Shake your head, thumbs up. Good, okay, all right. All right, good. So let's see, where was I? All right, so you're doing the tour, and remember, these are things that you want to try to point out to people that they can't see from looking at the pictures. I mean, we have got some great photographers, great videographers now that really, you know, what you have on the MLS, the pictures, the videos are showing up. So what can you bring that is different, again, that is going to excite people? So you want to look at, you know, like the comments that you have and bring something a little bit more to it. Like, you don't need to tell everyone, oh, this is a 3-bedroom, 2-bath with crown molding and granite countertops. They're pretty much going to be able to see that and to figure that out. So, you know, what else can you say about the house? One thing that I tried to do when I was an agent is I would always ask the client, what was it that made you fall in love with this house? And so kind of starting out your tour, that's something that you can share to your audience and say, hey, you know, I talked to my homeowner and they shared with me that the reason why they purchased this house is because it has pocket doors. Let me show you over here and how that works. So just kind of something like that. And, you know, you really want to excite people to be able to, you know, to ask questions and get the comments going in there too. And again, so when you're starting it out, you can announce, hey, you know, anyone that that comments on this will go into a drawing. And again, you know, you can sponsor it. Some of your partners can sponsor it. Something else that really works well too is to make sure that you have a lender on there, because of course you're listing the house, but you want to sell it. And so a lot of people right now are just unsure about getting loans. What does that mean? How do they qualify? You know, what they're looking for. And so I would say, you know, after having me on there, the next most important person would definitely be, you know, a lender. And, you know, I mean, even if you have a couple of lenders on there, but to be able to give people the, you know, some information, they can drop their info in the chat and the comments and everything. You know, I mean, you could even, if you're doing a video, you may be even to have them say something in the video. Okay, where am I? So, and again, something else too, that's really important. There's Universal Title is doing e-closings. And so that means that for sellers and for cash buyers, we can do everything all over the internet. So not everyone is doing that. So, I mean, you definitely want to check with them and see if that's something that is, you know, an option, but it's definitely going to add more to that selling point too, that, hey, you know, we can take care of you. I know that there's a lot of title companies that are doing like drive-by closings, so you can drive up and your clients, basically we're sending the documents to them ahead of time, seeing if they have any questions. So when they actually come to, you know, they're basically just signing the documents that the lender has requested, but we've gone over everything ahead of time with that. So in any questions about that part, guys?
Okay. So again, when you're doing this video, and if I don't know if any of you guys have noticed, but because I can see myself, I am smiling at myself the entire time. So when you are looking in your camera, make sure that you're smiling, because that is going, that's what's going to come out to everyone. So just, you know, practice that quite a bit. You know, we're all gonna, I mess up all the time. Don't worry about it, guys. Just keep on going. Remember, you're your biggest critic. So just, you know, get out there, try it, test it, get some of your friends maybe for the first time to give you, you know, some pointers or something like that. So again, when I talked about in step one was getting it set up, is you wanna have a script. So now when you're doing the presentation, you want to make sure that you are hitting the key points that you want people to know. So, I mean, like right here, I've just got some little notes. Yes, most all of just a little bit of notes. Most all this is coming from my head and from my heart, because that's the way that I do business. So, but just, you know, having some little notes on there, some things that you really want to point out. And so you want to take people through the house like they would be going, you know, dining room, living room, kitchen, you know, that kind of thing, you know, main level master, you know, and this would be too, though, that like if you're trying to show what a great view of the backyard, like you can't necessarily see that in a picture. But man, if you're standing there live, you know, then you can say, hey, guys, you know, look at this view out here. Or if, you know, you're standing in the kitchen and you're talking about the view from the kitchen window, or the way that the kitchen is amazing for entertaining, you know, pan around and show how, hey, I'm standing here cooking, or I'm standing here at the island, and look at how that I can see all of my guests out there. So again, just kind of pointing some of those things out, and you may practice this six times before before you even do it, and it's okay. So again, you wanna take everyone on the tour of the house. Basically, because again, you know, different people are kind of coming on, at different times. I mean, like even today, we've had people jump on, jump off because, either they don't want to hear me talk or they've just had other things going on and things that they need to do. And so you're going to find that when you're doing this as well. So you're actually going to take people on a tour twice. So just remember that the first time is definitely going to be longer and a little bit more in depth. And then just kind of walk through again and save a couple of things that you can throw out there for when you take people on the tour again. Okay. I would also, again, recommend, you know, a lot of us are working from home in our pajamas, but when you're doing this video presentation, I would recommend that you not be in your pajamas. Remember, you are still presenting yourself as a professional in the industry. So, you know, definitely want to make sure that you do that. Even some people are doing like the jacket on top and pajama bottoms on the bottom. Remember that when you're walking around in a house, there's going to be mirrors. So you don't want anyone checking out in a mirror that you maybe don't have yourself all put together. Something else that I've heard that's kind of fun to keep people interested in it is to play a game of I Spy. So you can put something in the house that as you're going around on the tour, that you're asking people to find. And then at the end, they can drop in their comments and see if they found it and where it was. I would suggest having people put it in when the video is over, because if people are commenting on it, then everyone kind of sees it. So it may be fun to do that, or pick out like a different color and say, okay, you know, I spy something wine. Now, if you walked around in my house, yes. Oh, okay. Hey guys, Sharon, just put something on here. I love your picture. It's your smiling face. So you're smiling at me the whole time, Sharon. Yeah. So gimbal is a product that holds your phone. Yeah. So it is a stabilizer. Good. Awesome. Mm-hmm. Yep. So, yeah. So, it's GIMBAL is the way that Sharon has it, on there. And it does, it hooks onto your phone. So it just keeps it from doing all the shaking. Thank you very much. So anyway, so that's kind of some way to get some interaction in there. And you know, like trying with a different, like I spy. Some of you guys have seen that going around on Facebook. You know, I spy something red. Show me the, you know, red picture on your phone or whatever. But again, it's just kind of something to make it a little bit more interactive. Okay. All right. So that's step two, is the presentation. Anybody have any questions about the presentation, about doing the video, doing it live?
I do.
Yes.
So I, unlike you, am a little camera shy. So
yes, but you're great with a hammer, Linda. Or was it a nail gun?
I don't think I'm going to bring a hammer to the open house.
Okay.
But is it okay to walk through and do a commentary and just show the house and not necessarily show the face? Or is it better to...
Very, very good point, Linda. Actually, yep, very good. So you need to make sure that you're doing this, again, on that gimbal product and some different things you can add to your phone. You have to look on there, and when you're doing it, you hit like a little button and it says flip screen. So typically you're going to be starting out, it's going to be your face there and saying welcome, and then you're going to flip it and show the house.
Okay, that works.
Yes.
So, and then the other thing too, and I think you mentioned it and my ears didn't hear all of it, but having been stalked a couple of times and once seriously at an open house, I would urge, because you are live, to definitely have somebody else there with you for safety.
Right. Yes.
Just from my own experience.
Yep.
So.
Yes. I mean, definitely very, very good point. You may not have anybody else in the video. But again, you can also say, you know, our homeowners are, you know, waiting outside until we're done, or, you know,
anything, or, you know, to make it look like somebody else.
Right. Or, you know, thanks to my husband who's waiting out in the car for me, or, you know, or I would say, you know, thanks to my future husband that's waiting out.
Especially if you're doing like a boosted event, you're telling everyone, this is where I'm going to be and I'm going to be alone kind of thing. That's
yes.
True.
Yeah, no, I would definitely not advertise. Don't advertise that you're alone. So sorry, if I gave that impression to anyone, I apologize. Yes, we're definitely not advertising that you're alone. I was just saying that when you're doing the video, there's typically no one else that's going to be in the video with you. Okay. So something else that you can do too, the Community Service Committee is still making the month of May for Community Service Month for all of FAR. And I know that there's so many people here, you know, that we know, you know, my daughter's already been laid off. My son's hours have been cut to less than half. So, you know, there's lots of people that are just dealing with things, you know, that word unprecedented. So something else that you can do too, is just say, you know, for everyone that likes my video, I will make a donation to a local charity. So again, just another way that you can try to get that in there. The community service page is making up lists of different charities. I know something that's on there right now is you can go on there and make a monetary donation to the food bank. Like, you really just go on there and you like click and you shop and you pay and it's done and it's that easy. So that would be something else too, that again, I think you're still trying to show that you're, you know, you're the professional, you're the one that's standing out, but you're also the one that gives back to the community. Okay. Any other questions about the actual presentation? Good. Okay. All right. Moving on. So then the last thing you want to do is go ahead.
I'm still learning where all the buttons are, you know.
It's okay.
So as you're going through the house, I know, you know, when you're there with the person live, they will be looking in kitchen cabinets.
Right.
Sometimes opening the refrigerator, closets.
Right.
So is that something that you would do or no?
So again, great question, Linda. And that's actually something that I have done again on the several virtual open house tours that I have done is like when someone walks through the kitchen and they say that it's a pantry, I will type in the comments, hey, Linda, can you open that pantry for us? And so again, I mean, that's where, you know, it does take a little bit of practice because you're trying to go through the house, you're trying to speak intelligently, you're trying to walk, and then you're also trying to read the comments a little bit. But I mean, but again, that's where something too, where, you know, I mean, even if it's just your best friend that is on there, but making the comments and saying, hey, you know, can you open up that pantry? Or, hey, you know, I want to see just how big that tub is. Can you stand in the tub? Or you know, what?
Oh, that's a good shot, Sherry.
So, but again, you know, I mean, if you're, you know, sitting down at the kitchen table or something like that and saying, okay, you know, this is really the spatial view, or this is really what I'm looking at. If I'm looking out, you know, into the backyard or side yard or whatever. So yes, the answer is yes. And the best way to do that again is to kind of get people to ask you those questions.
And I guess you're trying to, as you're doing the video, to give spatial dimension,
mm-hmm.
I don't know what you call it, but.
Yeah, no, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And so again, if you know that it's tight quarters, like in one room, I probably wouldn't, you know, you gotta be careful. You don't
move in furniture. Yeah.
Well, yes. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Any other questions? Okay. All right. So moving on to step three, which is the follow through and the follow up. And so this is where, you know, after you've done your event, after everything has, you know, it'll show up on your feed, even if you do it live, it'll keep going back on there. You can share the event again, you can share the video again. And so what you want to do is basically to go on to every comment and reply. So you're going to reply. And now, I mean, if someone's just been making like a lot of obnoxious comments, like me, you don't have to reply to everyone. But you at least want to reply and tag that person's name and thank them for being there or thank them for that question. And as they're writing comments and you're replying to them, again, that's also keeping your event that is going to show up on people's news feeds. Like when we talk about things going viral, it's because of the amount of times that things have been shared, that likes, but then also it's the comments on there. And when you can tag other, you know, other people, or if you have some information that you can put on there and you're tagging those people, then it shows up in their feed and their feed and their feed. Okay. And then what I did is then I did a live drawing for everyone that attended. So I went on to the comments and just let everyone know, hey, I put all of your names in here, and I let it go for about a day. Because again, you know, people that weren't there live were kind of, you know, were looking on there and liking it and asking questions and stuff like that. So I put everything, you know, did the drawing live, and then tagged those people in there. And so again, I was telling the name of the house, you know, the address again, the agent, but that's something that you as an agent can do as well. You know, I mean, again, you can just decide, you can also decide to do the drawing, you know, right then and there. If you do have someone that's there and helping you that can write the names down, you can do your drawing right then and there. So, but the most important thing, like I said, is the follow up and the follow through, and like the people that shared your live feed, you know, or shared the video, definitely want to thank them. People that commented on there, people that liked, you just want to go through and you want to thank them, and especially if it's someone that is a potential buyer, obviously, you know, that's a great time that you can just send them, you know, a message through Facebook or say, hey, you know, get in touch, you know, want to put you in touch with the right person. If it's some of your coworkers, again, too, you know, just want to, you know, thank them for their support. And I think that that's something that is really just so important right now, is that we are encouraging each other, because there is definitely a lot of scary things going on. So, oh yes, thank you. Thanks, Barb. I appreciate that. That's my email on there that you can follow up with me. But you know, but like I tell most people, you can call me, you can text me, you can email me, send me a message through Facebook, send me a message through Instagram, even carrier pigeon, whatever it takes. I will definitely respond and answer your questions. All right. So does anybody have any questions about the follow-up?
Sorry, I'm slow here again. One question, do you advertise when you're doing the follow-up so that the people who were there know what you're...
Yes, yep. So again, I mean, some of this stuff has been kind of like on the fly, and so we've learned to put it in there, you know, later. And so that's what I'm kind of telling people to do now. Like if you want to say, hey, we'll be doing a live drawing tomorrow at this time. So if you can already have that set up, you know, then that would be great. You can put that video into the actual event. You can do it separate, have it posted to their page. So there's a lot of different options on there. And again, you have to figure out like what works best for you. Bright has again updated their system so that you can click on there and let people know that there is a virtual open house tour. So I know that that's something that FAR has sent out, and you know, we verified it and everything. It may be another agent with their client that's watching it. Wouldn't that be great? And then you get off the phone, get ratified contract. Whoop, whoop. All right, guys, any other questions? Come on, somebody bring me a question. Caitlin, are you still on there? Are you still here? I see you're muted, but I didn't know if you were still here. All right, I'll just, yes, Caitlin.
Yeah.
So I know that you work with a lot of agents up in Northern Virginia more, but is there something that you've noticed that maybe it's a little bit different, anything that you can add from what you've seen other agents do?
I did see one who did a scavenger hunt, which is really similar to what you mentioned about iSpy, pretty much.
Right. Okay.
Where you would pick five or however many items in the house before you do the tour and list those out. You can also, that can be an event as well. So people are prepared for it, and then they're looking for those items as you go through the house. And then at the end, you tell them to email you with the location of the items or screenshots. And again, you would draw a name for the winner. So it's just making it interactive.
Okay.
More doing things versus just watching an open house.
All right, cool. Great. Awesome. Thank you.
No problem.
Caitlin works at our main office in McLean. And before she was hired, she was warned about me. So, but I would call on her at any point in time.
Love it.
All right, guys. How about a takeaway? I mean, what's one thing that you got from this that you're like, oh, wow, this is great. Share this with other people, take it back to your offices, or maybe just keep it to yourself and then you have all the contracts. I don't know. What? Anything? You guys can take yourself off mute. Please feel free to.
I like that you set a time frame for this, that it can be 30 minutes or it can be less. I like the fact that you can do it multiple times so you can make it a scavenger hunt, interactive or iSpy or however you want to do that. And I did not realize that Bright allowed us to put the virtual open house out. So thank you.
Awesome. Yeah, guys, and again, as I've been putting this together, it really has been other agents, other lenders, you know, my girl Kelly up there in the top right corner with Choice. Yes, I did a lot of practicing on her. you know, the staff at FAR, you know, watching webinars and stuff like that. I mean, so it really is just trying to take the information that I found out and what's worked for other people. And again, it is all changing. So invite me to yours. Give me some feedback. I mean, even if I've shared something with you and you said, hey, this didn't really work as well as I thought, that's okay too. Because again, we are all trying to work and navigate through this together. And together we will overcome. Yes. all right. Yeah. Yes. All right. Yeah. So, Sharon said definitely ways to make it more interactive. Got a thumbs up from Barb. Yes. We were supposed to be on a girls' trip today. Instead, we're doing Zoom calls. so something else too. Let me just. I know a lot of people are doing this on Zoom.
We missed our wine tour too, Cher.
Yes. Oh, I know. We had so many wonderful things planned that we'll all be doing. I tell you what, like June 11th, I'm not sleeping. I'm doing everything that I was supposed to be doing, all on June 11th. So. But you can also set this up where you can invite people to come in for like a Google Hangout. So again, that's just another option. I know that a lot of people are getting on Zoom now, but you know, not everyone knows that, feels comfortable with it. So Google Hangouts is another one too. You can just send everyone an email, and then they click on a link and it goes into to Google Hangouts. You know, that way you also too may be able to keep track a little bit more about who's there. So Zoom, Facebook Live, and Google Hangouts are the three things that I am recommending. All right, so I am putting, So my friend, Sean Derrick, who's been down here for about 5 years now. Hold on, let me see what else he sent me. So, I am going to be on his, we were trying to look at the time. So he is starting it at 12:30 because I figured you guys might need some time to go, you know, answer calls from all your clients that have been calling you all morning while we've been on this call. Go grab some lunch and then come back and join us. I will also share it on my page too. So come back at 12:30 and you can kind of see a little bit of the interaction. Hold on just one second. I'm looking on here. I do not see the address that is on here. I'm just looking at my phone. I did set a reminder, but that will be on there. And again, you know, just kind of come on and check and see. Get some different ideas. And the most important thing, guys, is just remember that this is you. It's a representation of you. So don't try to be anybody else. Just try to be you. And it will definitely come through in your videos to your clients. This is also something else too. It may not be your listing, or if you don't feel comfortable doing the open house tour, then you know someone else in your office could also do it for you. And that way you're still working together. You're still getting it out there. You know, because the clients that have got their houses listed, I mean, there is a, you know, more often than not is a need to sell. So we actually are still providing a service and taking care of our clients to help them get their house sold. And, you know, again, there are people that, you know, that are needing, you know, to move. So. And you can decide if you want to wear gloves, if you want to wear a mask. You know, again, that's up to you. If the house is going to be open, to come in and still tour, people are setting up like strict appointment times. They're putting little baskets, by the front door where it has the booties, the gloves, the masks and the wipes. So, you know, if you have that in this house, I recommend that you do make sure you take a little picture of that.